You'd be amazed with the things that you can draw or construct if you have a straight edge and a compass. And a straight edge is literally just something that has a straight edge that allows you to draw straight lines, like a ruler. And a compass is something that allows you to draw circles centered where you want them to be centered of different radii. And your typical compass would be like a metal thing. It has a pin on one end, and it's kind of shaped like an angle, and then you have a pencil at the other end. Now, I don't have real physical rulers and pencils in front of me, but I have the virtual equivalent. I can say add a compass, and now I can draw a circle. I can pick where I want to center it, and I can change the radius. And I can draw a straight line segment. So I can move it around, and I can draw. This is equivalent to having a straight edge. And so using these tools, I want to construct a line going through P that is tangent to the circle. Now, it might be tempting, let me just try to draw a line. Maybe it looks something like this. Do you remember a tangent line will touch the circle exactly one point, and that point, since it's going through B, should be the point P. Another way to think about a tangent line is it's going to be perpendicular to the radius between that point and the center. Now, what I just drew actually looks pretty good, but it's not so precise. I don't know if it's exactly perpendicular to the radius. I don't know if it's touching at exactly one point right over there. So what we're going to do is use our virtual compass and our virtual straight edge to try to do a more precise drawing. So let's do that. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set up P as the midpoint of a line where the center of the circle is one other end of the line. And the way I can do that, let me add a compass here. And let me construct a circle that has the same, okay, so I've set up my compass to have the same radius as my original circle. But now let me move it over, right over here. So now it's centered at P. Well, why is this useful? Well, now a diameter of this new circle is going to be a segment that is centered at P. So I'm going to have a segment where P is the midpoint, and then my center of my original circle is going to be one of the endpoints. So let's do that. So I'm going to add a straight edge. So I'll make that one of the endpoints. And I want to go through P all the way to the other side of my new circle. Now, what's the whole point of me? Let me try to do it as well as I can. What's the whole point of me doing that? Well, now I've made P the midpoint of a segment. So if I can construct a perpendicular bisector of the segment, it will go through P because P is the midpoint. And then that thing is going to be, it's going to be exactly perpendicular to the radius, because the original radius is part of this segment. So let's see how I could do this. So what I could do is I'm gonna draw another circle. I'm gonna center this one at the original circle. And I'm going to make it have a different radius, maybe a radius something like that. And now I'm going to construct another circle of this larger size, but I'm going to center it at this point right over here. And I think you'll see quickly what this will accomplish. So I'm going to construct another circle of that same larger radius, just like that. And now I'm going to move it over here. So what's interesting about the intersection of these two larger circles? Well, this point right over here is equidistant to this end of the segment and to this end of the segment. Because remember, these two larger circles have the same radius. So if I'm sitting on both of them, then I am that distance away from this point, and I am sitting that distance away from this point. So something that is equidistant from the two endpoints of a segment, it's going to sit on the perpendicular bisector. So this point is going to sit on the perpendicular bisector, and this point is going to sit on the perpendicular bisector. So now we can draw a perpendicular bisector. We can go from this point right over here, the intersection of our two larger circles, this point that is equidistant from my two centers of the large circle, to this point that is equidistant to the two centers of the large circle. And once again, it's equidistant to the two centers of the large circle, but those points are also the endpoints of this segment. So these two points are on the perpendicular bisector. You just need two points for a line. So I've just constructed a perpendicular bisector to P, and it's perpendicular, once again, to the radius of our original, the radius from the center to P of our original circle. Now that is going to be a tangent line. Because this, right, if we go only through P, or we go through P and we are exactly perpendicular to the radius from P to the center, then this line that we've just constructed is actually tangent. So anyway, it might seem like a lot of work to do all of this. You know, I could have started just eyeballing it. But when we do it like this, we can feel really, 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 really good that we're being precise. Imagine if you were trying to do this on a larger scale, or if you're trying to engineer some very precise instrument, you would want to do it this way. You want to draw a very precise drawing, maybe an architectural drawing. This could be an interesting way to approach it. And you know, in times past, before folks had things like computers and whatever else, this was a thing people actually did.